Hello everyone, I hope everyone are safe and sound, staying indoor, healthy, fit and fine. Today, I and my team members are here to present our science activity works through the method of social distancing during this epidemic crisis. Our topic is matter and solar system. We will start our presentation with Shayana Safi of class 5 to show us experiments on sedimentation, decantation and filtration.
Hello friends, my name is Aima Safi and I study in class 5 section A in Happy Government School, Dhubri. My topic is experiment of sedimentation, decantation and filtration. So today I am going to show you all the experiment of sedimentation, decantation and filtration. So for this to do, I have taken one glass and now I am going to add soil. So I have added soil, now I am going to add water. Now I am going to mix it. So I have mixed it.
Ready.
So after a few minutes later, the soil settled down and the water has come upward, and this process is called sedimentation. And now I am going to pour this water into another glass. So I have poured this water into another glass and this process is called decantation. And now I am going to do filtration. So for doing filtration, I have taken filter paper, cone and one glass. And now I am going to fold this filter paper. So I have folded this filter paper and now I am going to put this filter paper in the cone. And now I am going to pour water. So after a few minutes later, the clean water has come down and now I am going to show you all the condition of filter paper. So this is the condition of filter paper. All the dust remains in the paper and this process is called filtration. So this is the process of sedimentation, decantation and filtration. Thank you.
Hello everyone, today I will discuss about states of matter. States of matter are classified as three states. They are called solid, liquid and gases. Solid. A solid has a definite shape and volume. Its shape cannot change until some external force are applied to on it. The force of attraction between molecules are the highest. Also, solids do not dissolve in air. Examples of solids. They are ice, rock, book, chair, etc., etc. Liquid. A liquid is defined as a volume but does not have definite shape. It takes the shape of the container in which it is kept on. The force of attraction between molecules in liquid are less than solids. Like solid, liquid also do not dissolve in air. Examples of liquid are juice, water, oil, etc., etc. Gases. A gas neither has a definite shape nor a definite volume. It occupies all the container in which it is kept. In gases, the force of attraction between molecules are the least. They have to sit in the they have to sit closer to each other than a gas can be compressed. Gases of are oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen.
Hello everyone, my name is Rulabin Ahmed. I am reading in class 5 section B. Today my topic is based on satellite. A satellite is an object in space that orbit something else. There are two kinds of satellite. One is natural and another is man-made satellite. Satellite as a relay from signals from one point on the ground to another. It also relay televisions and radio signals from the broadcast point.
Good morning, my name is Shamsa Afzal. I read in class 5, section C, rule number 15. My topic is solar system. The solar system is consist of 8 planets called Mercury, Venus, Earth, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. Among them we live in the planet called Earth. This is the only planet which consists of life. Our solar system also consists of one star called the Sun.
Hello everyone, today I am going to tell about our solar system. The solar system is the system of the Sun and the object that orbit it, either directly or indirectly, of the object that orbit the Sun directly. The largest are the 8 planets, with the remainder being small objects, the dwarf planets and small solar bodies. The 8 planets are Mercury, being the smallest planet, Venus, the hottest planet, Earth, the only planet with water on the surface, Mars, the red planet due to the rest in the soil, Jupiter, the largest planet, Saturn, the brightest planet having rings, Uranus, it's trapped on its axis by almost 90 degrees, Neptune, the farther planet. Thank you everyone.
This is called solar eclipse. Hello, my name is Farhan Afzal. I am from class 5, section C, row number 14. My topic is about eclipse. Eclipse are of two types, solar eclipse and lunar eclipse. Solar eclipse. A solar eclipse occurs when a portion of the Earth is covered in a shadow cast by the moon, which fully or partially blocks sunlight. This occurs when the Sun, Moon, and Earth are aligned. This is the lunar eclipse. Lunar eclipse. Lunar eclipse occur when the moon moves into the Earth's shadow. This can occur only when the Sun, Earth and Moon are exactly or very closely aligned with Earth. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I am Hardik of class 5 from Happy Convent School, and today I am going to explain about physical and chemical change. Physical change. Changes in which no new substances are formed are called physical change. It is a temporary change. There is a change, but we can bring things back. For example, melting of an ice. You can see here, melting of an ice. Here we have a cube of ice. Let it stay for some time and then it will melt into water. You can see here, it will melt into water sometimes. So it's changed from solid state to liquid state. But this change can be reversed. That is, we can freeze this same water into ice. It is a physical change and a reversible change. So next example is crushing of a paper. You can see here, I have taken a piece of a paper and now I will crush it. When we have crushed the paper, it has changed its shape and size. But we have just changed the shape and we have got the paper back. So I can change back into its normal size. The crushed paper, we can change it back into its normal size. You can see here, we have changed the back on normal size. So next is chemical change. The changes in which new substances are formed are called chemical change. They are permanent in nature and cannot be reversed. For example, you can see here, for example, burning of a paper. So here I have taken a piece of a paper and now I will burn it. When I will burn it, you can see here, now the paper is burning. You can see the paper is now burning and here is the hot ash, you can see, and the smoke is also coming out. With the burning hot ash, smoke is also coming out. It changed new type of matter is formed, that is gas, that is ash. You can see here that the new type of matter has been formed, that is ash. And you can see here ash, this ash cannot change back into paper, and now it is a irreversible change and chemical change. So next example is rusting of an iron. You can see here, rusting of an iron, when a metal undergoes rusting, a new type of matter is formed, which is totally different from the original metal, and rusting cannot be changed to, rusting is a chemical change and also an irreversible change. So it is a rusted iron and cannot be changed into original iron. So next is burning of a candle. You can see here, we have burnt candle. When we have lighted the candle, so after sometimes the candle reduces and becomes small. First this candle was fat, large and fat, but now it has thin and small candle. The candle reduces time to time and we cannot convert the small candle and to the its original shape and size, we cannot convert. So this is all about physical and chemical change. I want to thank all of you for watching our project. Thank you and have a great day.
Those were all such beautiful presentations by my team members. I thank each of them for their beautiful cooperation and presentation. Thank you for watching our presentation. Stay safe and sound. Thank you.